Hello and good evening, this is Ruth Pozuelo from Curval.com, and today is time again for DAX Fridays. And we are going to use this function summarize to actually demonstrate how it works, but also to make a correction on the video I showed you previously. It is actually the video where we created KPIs, and there is a small mistake that we need to correct. And the way to do it is by using summarize. So I thought it was a perfect way to demonstrate how this DAX function works. So without any more delay, let's start. So here we have the report where I show you how to get these icons, KPI icons in your Power BI table lists. And this is how the report looks like when you download it from the video. But if you sort by product name, look what happens. What we see here is the same product twice, and we get a KPI, a green one and a red one. I'm going to show you why in a minute, but I want to show you how I found out about this. So I got a comment this morning from Lasse that he was a bit confused because he was seeing exactly that behavior, that the same product was listed twice. And he actually understood why, and he was just a bit unsure on how to move forward. So let me show you why this problem is happening and how we can solve it in case you also have that problem. So for those of you that are new to this video, make sure that you check the KPI video first so you understand what I'm talking about. Otherwise, you can just download this new file and everything will work correctly. But to create this icon URLs, we actually create a calculated column in our order detail fact table. I'm sure you remember that. So we had a column for the total sales, and then we said if the total sales are bigger than 1,000, then write 5, otherwise write 6. And then we had a relationship with our KPI table that we said the arrow KPI goes to the icon key. And this is how our icon key looks like. So 5 and 6 is a green circle and a red circle. So the problem here is, here we have sorted product ID by ascending. So what we can see here is, because this is a calculated column, is being evaluated or calculated row by row, okay? So it goes to this row and it said, okay, is total sales bigger than 1,000? It says 180, so it's yes, no, so, sorry. So no, then it writes a 6, goes to the next column. Total sales bigger than 1,000, no, it's 360, so it writes a 6. So this works until it finds a row that is over 1,000. Here we have one, okay? So in this case, it returns a 5. And then when we go into our visualization, then it adds all the 5s and gives us one row, and then it adds all the 6 and give us another row. And that's where we get the two indicators. So this is not the behavior that we want to get. And I'm sure that because I haven't heard anything by now, and it's like over 1,000 views, that you already figured it out. But if there's somebody new that would like to use it, I want to show how to correct this. So what we're going to do to fix this is we're going to create a calculated table that we're going to summarize or group the total sales by product, so we don't have any repeat products like we do here. So we will have only one product ID, one with the total sum, and then we will get an arrow KPI. And to do that, we just go to new table. We can call this sales KPI, And then we're going to summarize. And here it says, first the table. It is the order details that we want to summarize. Then group by, and we want to group by product ID. So we write product ID from the order table. It doesn't get it. So order detail product ID. So it's going to group by product ID, and we want to have total sales. And our total sales is the sum of order details, total sales. So now we are getting exactly what we want. Let's do this zero. So we have unique product IDs here with their total sales. So this is good, because now when we are creating our calculated column again, modified KPI, we do exactly the same again. If sales KPI total sales bigger than, now it has to be bigger because almost all the sales are bigger than 1,000, then 5, or let's say 1, otherwise 2, I think is arrows in this case, I don't remember exactly, but it will work. So now we have to fix the relations. So we go back here, and we're going to disconnect these two. And this one is going to be now in the middle. So modify KPI is going to go with our icon key. And product ID is going to go with our product tables, which is in here. Let's put this. So we can get the product name, right? So now we go back. And total sales are these total sales. And the icon will be correct. So now we have one product, one icon, which is what we would like to have. And if we add the categories and category name, we will still get one and is functioning as it should, even if it's in another table. Thank you so much for watching. If you like the video, please let me know by liking it. If you have any comments, questions, or suggestions, let me know either in the comment box or any of the social channels listed below. And subscribe. I publish Power BI videos every week. Have a nice evening. Bye.